Good morning, students. This is Smita Vla Pandey from NLK Group of Schools. Today, we are here with a new topic, kinds of materials. I hope you all are safe at your places. So, we'll talk about kinds of materials. Students, we see wide variety of objects around us. These objects have different shapes, sizes, and colors. They're also made of different materials. Some objects are made up of paper, while others are made of soil, mud, or wood. All objects we use are made of materials. Materials can be of two types, natural material or man-made materials. Natural materials, materials that come from plants, animals, and rocks, or the materials that we obtain from nature are called natural materials. For example, ivory, leather, wool, wood, or clay. Natural materials. After this, we have man-made materials. Man-made materials are the materials which are made by man through chemical processes. For example, bricks, steel, glass, paper, or plastic. Property of a material. How a material looks and feels like is called its property. Materials have different properties that make them useful for different jobs or purposes. Properties of materials can be mentioned here. Shiny or dull, rough or smooth, hard or soft, strong or weak, waterproof or absorbent, transparent or translucent or opaque, flexible or rigid, elastic or inelastic, magnetic or non-magnetic, heat conductor or an insulator. Shiny or dull. Materials that reflect a lot of light or have lustrous appearance are called shiny materials. For example, glass, gold ring, diamond, steel spoon, silver coin, etc. Dull, material that reflects less light or are non-lustrous in nature are called dull materials. Example, chalk, brick, newspaper, wooden spoon, rubber, etc. Rough or smooth, materials that have uneven surface are called rough materials. For example, sandpaper, screw, starfish, pineapple, bark of a tree, etc. Smooth. Materials that have even surfaces are called smooth materials. For example, glass bowl, mirror, marble, paper, CD, etc. Hard or soft materials. Hard materials that are difficult to scratch are called hard materials. For example, diamond, pottery, remote, rock, etc. Soft materials are the materials that are easy to scratch. For example, towel, cushion, jelly, pillow, feather. Strong or weak materials. Strong materials that are difficult to break are called strong materials. For example, steel knife, spade, iron ruler, rock, etc. Weak materials are the materials that are easy to break. For example, ceramic mug, plastic ruler, glass, chalk, etc. Waterproof or absorbent. Materials that do not let water to pass through them are called waterproof materials. For example, an umbrella, a raincoat, Vaseline jelly, plastic bottle, etc. Absorbent. Materials that let water pass through them or that take up water are called absorbents. For example, paper, hair, wood, socks, etc. Transparent, translucent or opaque. Transparent, materials that allow light to pass through them easily are called transparent materials. For example, hand lens, glass window, spectacles, glass beaker, etc. Translucent, materials that allow light to pass through them partially are called translucent material. For example, plastic bag, wax paper, shower curtain, lampshade, etc. Opaque, materials that do not let light to pass through them are called opaque objects. For example, wooden toy, candle, door, concrete wall, etc. Flexible or rigid. Materials that are easy to bend are called flexible materials. For example, rubber toy, rubber band, tissue, cardboard, etc. Rigid or stiff. Materials that are difficult to bend are called rigid or stiff materials. For example, metal key, plastic toy, iron nail, brick, wooden lock, etc. Elastic or inelastic. Materials that can be stretched are called elastic materials. For example, rubber band, chewing gum, springs, balloon, etc. Inelastic. Materials that cannot be stretched are called inelastic materials. For example, remote, hammer, plastic cup, gold ring, kitchen foil, etc. Students, we hope that this topic is clear to you all. Now, we'll meet again with our another topic. So for now, thank you for watching this.